Hello students, how are you? So you remember what I taught you yesterday? No, that is why I want to check. Do you remember this diagram? This is of heart. We did it yesterday. Okay, now what is this? Can you label it? This is right uricle, right ventricle, left uricle and left ventricle. It is very easy to remember. This was the size of your heart and where your heart is situated. It is here. It is located here. Simple. This side is right and this side is left. The above portion is right uricle. RA, because A is the first letter. Then the lower is right ventricle, because ventricle comes after A. V comes after A. Then this is your left side. Okay. This is left uricle and this is left ventricle. It's very easy. Will you remember now? Good. Then, now from the veins, the blood is poured into right uricle. Very good. And after right uricle, it goes into right ventricle. And from left, right ventricle, it goes into lungs. I told you, never think that the right ventricle will give it to it. They will not give the blood, because this blood is deoxygenated blood, carbon dioxide blood. So they will give it to the lungs. Now what lungs will do? They will purify the blood and then they will pour the blood into left uricle, and from left uricle it will go into left ventricle, and from left ventricle it will move to the, where you want the blood to be supplied, the oxygenated blood should be given to the body. So the left ventricle will give the blood to the body. That blood which is having oxygen, that is distributed to the left ventricle, and then it is distributed to the whole body. Clear? Is it clear now? So today we are going to do functions of blood. Because you have seen the blood, it plays a very special role in the circulatory system. So the blood, it is having specific functions also from the body. What are the functions of blood? First of all, transporting digested food. I told you in the beginning, when you eat food, the nutrients of the food, they are absorbed by the blood. When your food, it goes into the stomach, what the stomach do? It changes into simple food, and that simple food is again passed to the small intestine, and from the small intestine the nutrients, they are passed to the blood. Okay, or these nutrients are given to the whole body. Suppose you are taking milk. Milk is a rich source of calcium. Now calcium is required by your bones, by your teeth. Now how can you give calcium to the body? The blood, it absorbs the calcium, everything, all the nutrients it absorbs from the intestine, and then it flows into the blood, and whichever organ require the nutrient, they take it. Suppose your bones, they require calcium, they will take calcium. Have you ever gone to a holy feast? Holy feast means langar. कभी लंगर खाया आपने गुरुद्वारे में या मंदिर में? तो आपने देखा होगा, जब आप बैठे होते हो तो एक जना क्या लेके आ रहा है, रोटी लेकर क्या रहा है, एक जना दाल लेकर क्या रहा है, आपको जिस चीज की जरूरत होती है आप वही चीज लेते हो ना, या सब कुछ लेते जाते हो. द थिंग विच यू रिक्वायर, सपोज आपको रोटी की जरूरत है तो आप उनसे रोटी ले लेते हो, जो दाल वाला आ रहा है आपको दाल चाहिए तो आप ले लेते हो, अदरवाइज आप उसको मना कर देते हो. सेम मैनर ब्लड इज कैरिंग ऑल द न्यूट्रिएंट्स विद इट. Because if we are having balanced diet, we are having proteins, we are having vitamins, minerals, calcium, everything we are having, and everything is transported to the blood, and blood flows in the body, and the organ that require that particular nutrient, it takes from the body. Suppose your cells which are growing, they need protein, they will take the protein from them. Suppose your bones, they need calcium, they will take calcium from the blood. Clear? So in this manner, the blood, it transports digested food. Digested food means it transports nutrients to the whole body. After that, this you all know, that the blood, it transports oxygen also, which we have seen that lungs give oxygen to the blood and blood flows in the body and giving oxygen to all the cells of the body. सभी सेल्स को ब्लड जो है वो ऑक्सीजन देता है और वहां से कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड ले लेता है, ठीक है. देन ट्रांसपोर्ट्स हार्मोन्स. हार्मोन्स आर वेरी इसेंशियल बिकॉज हार्मोन्स दे प्ले अ वेरी वाइटल रोल इन योर लाइफ. हार्मोन्स हेल्प यू इन डाइजेस्टिंग योर फूड, दे हेल्प यू टू ग्रो, दे हेल्प यू इन नंबर ऑफ एक्टिविटीज एंड दीज हार्मोन्स आर ऑल्सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड थ्रू द blood. Then it maintains body temperature. In fourth also I think you must have learned that there are two type of beings, cold-blooded and warm-blooded animals. Now what are warm-blooded? We are warm-blooded animals. Do you know this? Now what are warm-blooded animals? The animals or the beings that maintain their body temperature. What is your body temperature? Normal body temperature. Yes, it is 98.6. Okay, 98.6 degree. So our body needs to maintain this temperature. If there is cold outside and if we are feeling cold, what we will do? We will wear sweater. अगर बाहर सर्दी और हमें सर्दी लग रही है तो हम क्या करते हैं? स्वेटर पहन लेते हैं. बाहर गर्मी होती है और हमें गर्मी लग रही है तो हम क्या करते हैं? एसी, कूलर, फैन सब कुछ ऑन करते हैं ताकि हमारी बॉडी का टेम्परेचर मेंटेन रहे. और ये बॉडी टेम्परेचर हु मेंटेन्स दिस? बॉडी टेम्परेचर, ब्लड मेंटेन्स द बॉडी टेम्परेचर. क्योंकि बॉडी का टेम्परेचर जो बढ़ रहा है वो किसका बढ़ रहा है? दैट इज ऑफ ब्लड. बॉडी का टेम्परेचर कम हो रहा है वो किसका हो रहा है? दैट इज ऑफ ब्लड. तो ब्लड ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन द मेंटेनिंग बॉडी टेम्परेचर. आफ्टर दैट water level of water. All of you know that we should drink plenty of water. How many glass of water should we drink really? 8 to 10 glasses of water. Why? What is happening? Blood is flowing and all of you know that blood is flowing in arteries and veins, capillaries. Capillaries are very thin tubes aur patli tubes hain, unke andar liquid to bade aaram se flow karega, lekin jaise wo liquid thoda sa thick hua, what will happen? It will not flow. Have you seen custard? Custard dekha hai sabne? So custard is a viscous liquid. Viscous means thoda sa gaadha. Aur pani aur custard mein if you see both difference hai. Water is very diluted form and custard is a viscous form. Thoda sa hard hota hai, dark hota hai. Gaadha hota hai thoda sa. To agar hum pani nahi piyenge, if we will not drink water, what will happen? The blood, our blood will become thick. And it will become very hard for the blood to flow into the capillaries. That is why our body tells us we are thirsty, we need water. And so we go and have a glass of water, because when the blood, it becomes thick, it will not flow. And it will not flow. What happens if the blood not flows? Do you know? You can get a heart attack also. Why people get heart attack? Because the blood, it becomes dark, it becomes viscous and it flows with a very slow speed in their body, and that is why they get heart attack. Or if there is some blockage in their tubes, in their capillaries, then also they get heart attack because the blood don't flow properly. That is why the blood also manages the water level in the body. Then removal of waste material. I told you in the beginning that our all the cells, they are producing carbon dioxide, they are producing waste material in the body. Now how this waste material is removed from the body? Through sweat. Paseena aata hai aapko? Us paseene se jo gandagi hai body ki wo bhi bahar nikalti hai. Theek hai? Aur by passing urine, by passing feces, ye bhi, isse bhi aapki body ki jo gandagi hai, that is also removed. And then blood also helps you to do all this. It transports the waste material and then give it to the excretory system and it is thrown out of the body. Now do you understand cold-blooded and warm-blooded animals? So Now the functions of blood, are they clear? Shall we revise it again? Transporting digested food. All the nutrients from the food, they are transported to the body parts through blood. Transporting of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Oxygen that is taken from the lungs and transported to the whole body, it is done with the help of blood. Transports, it also transports hormones. Then it maintains the body temperature. Your body temperature is maintained because of blood. Then water level of the body. Water level of the body is also maintained by the blood. Blood becomes thick and it gives you some signs that the blood is becoming thick and you need water, and then you have water. Then waste material. So waste material is also removed with the help of blood. Clear? Now in the beginning I told you that along with the heart we have blood vessels, which are arteries and veins. Now arteries and veins, we are going to see the difference. What is the difference between arteries and veins? What are arteries? Can you recall it? What are arteries? What do the arteries do? Yes, they take the blood away from the heart. And what kind of blood is having? When they take the blood away from the heart, what kind of blood they are having? Yes, they are having oxygenated blood. So arteries, they carry oxygenated blood. So veins, they carry deoxygenated blood. Clear? Arteries carry oxygenated blood and veins carry deoxygenated blood. Now arteries, they are deep seated. Deep seated means they are deep inside the body. If you see your wrist like this, can you see some blue color veins? Some blue color lines on your wrist? Yes, these are veins, because veins are not deep seated, they are superficial. जो आर्टरीज है वो बहुत अंदर होती है बॉडी के, स्किन के बहुत नीचे होती है, लेकिन जो वेन्स है वो ऊपर होती है, तभी आपको ये दिखाई दे रही है. इनके अंदर वाई दे आर ब्लू, क्योंकि इसके अंदर कौन सा ब्लड है? डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड. बिकॉज द वेन्स दे कैरी डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड, दैट इज वाई दे आर हैविंग ब्लू कलर, एंड द आर्टरीज दे आर हैविंग ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड. एंड द नेक्स्ट डिफरेंस इज आर्टरीज दे आर ऑफ थिक वॉल्स. आर्टरीज की जो वॉल्स है वो थिक होती हैं और वेन्स की जो वॉल्स है वो थिन होती हैं. अब आर्टरीज की वॉल्स थिक क्यों होती है और वेन्स की थिन क्यों होती है? बिकॉज द आर्टरीज दे आर, व्हाट दे आर डूइंग, दे आर गिविंग ऑल द थिंग्स टू द बॉडी. दे आर टेकिंग योर न्यूट्रिएंट्स, your hormones, oxygen, everything, and they are distributing to the body. That is why they are having thick wall. And veins, why they are having thin walls? Because your food, undigested food, is passed through the large intestine. Through the large intestine, they are passed to the veins. That is why they are having thin walls, so that the things, they are passed easily from the veins to the blood. Clear? That is why arteries and veins, the arteries have thick walls and veins have thin walls. Now these are the difference between arteries and veins. Again I am revising the same thing. Arteries and veins, you remember, arteries take the blood away from the heart, and the blood which is going away from the heart, that is having oxygen, and the blood that is coming to the heart, that is having carbon dioxide. So arteries contain oxygenated pure blood, veins contain deoxygenated impure blood. Arteries, they are deep seated, niche hoti hai andar, aur veins they are superficial, upar hoti hai, dikhai deti hai. Whenever you go for a blood test ke liye jaate ho, kabhi bhi wo yahan inme se blood nahi leta. कहाँ से लेता है? वो डीप जो आर्टरीज है आपकी, वहां से ब्लड सैंपल लेता है. कभी कर करवाया किसी ने ब्लड टेस्ट, तो द पर्सन ही टेक्स द ब्लड फ्रॉम द डीप फ्रॉम द आर्टरीज नॉट फ्रॉम द वेन्स. एंड देन आर्टरीज दे हैव थिक वॉल्स एंड द वेन्स दे हैव थिन वॉल्स. इज इट क्लियर ऑल द थिंग्स? सो रिमेंबर रिकॉल एवरीथिंग. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू वॉच ऑल द वीडियोज अगेन एंड देन क्वेरी टू योर सेल्फ. ओके थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.
जबी